All right, guys, we haven't filmed all day today. It's like 8 o'clock at night. Mike's still here, Cameron's here. They just left to the gas station and we just bought a new SD card at Walmart. And we've been working, guys. We've been working on the Saleen. We got the engine over here. You can barely see it right here behind Brent. Big rig's still in here. And Brent and Mike with 3E's prepped the whole engine bay for Christian's 87 Saleen 175. And it's ready to shoot. We got the front primered. We got behind here all undercoated, which we'll show when we take that off. Y'all see that tomorrow. I put some wire and a bolt through here with a nut to hold the hood hinges up, because that's what you're going to see whenever you have the hood propped up. So no shave on this. I know you guys are used to us shaving bays and filling holes and everything, but this is a Saleen, so we want to keep it stock. The sway bars are painted. We got brand new new old stock Saleen struts, which are Coney for it, and it's going good. We're going to raise it up. I'm going to be painting with it, lift it a little bit so I can get the transmission tunnel like we always do. And so that's kind of what's been going on today. I'm sure you guys are familiar with how cold it is in the U.S. right now. It's like, what, like 8 degrees right now?
It's even cold in the shop, and this place is insulated. I mean, it's cold out.
Yeah, it's cold.
You open the door, I mean, the sun went down at what, like 5 o'clock or something stupid? It was cold, had to take the trash out, didn't want to do that. But, I mean, it is warmer in here, but still look at me. I mean, like, I'm bundled up. But we're really excited. We actually also did, if you kind of look underneath here, we're going to spray a little bit of black underneath. Just so that if you don't spray this first black and your car's red and then you spray this the second time, that black is actually going to get in there and get in the engine bay. So it's always a good idea to, say, do undercoating or whatever you're going to do in the wheel wells before you do the engine bay.
Yeah, well, I kind of just didn't show that. Like I said, we just kind of been on the ball and just rolling around. I mean, Mike's getting ready to restore and rewrap some wires on Christian's wiring harness when he gets back. We did get a set of Mach 1 calipers in and a set of Cobra calipers in. These are for sale. I'm sure this video won't be up for probably a couple weeks after today's date. But you know, we always get them in. We don't always keep them in stock, but we can get them in, so you never know if we get them in or not. So if you guys want to be on a list for to purchase these and we can paint them for you, just let me know. So anyway, I didn't want to start spraying this. I mean, I know I did the primer and stuff, but once I start spraying it, you really won't see, you know, the results from before and after. So I just wanted to get on here. I did etch prime the little rust areas already. Just surface rust, nothing major. This Fox Body is very clean. There's actually no rust. I'm just kind of pissed off about how the pinch welds are. There's usually rust down there and rust in the shock towers. But the only thing this car had bad is the floor pans were jacked up on and the pinch welds were just folded over. So taped everything up. Took all the brake lines off, everything out. Throttle cable, clutch cable. Hood prop. I mean, these Fox bodies, they are hard work. They are a lot harder than the SN95 and New Edge, and I'm sure that's why Ford improved them to make them easier to work on and disassemble and reassemble. So these Fox bodies suck, but it's worth it because it's a Saleen, and we're doing Christian solid. He didn't even want us to paint the engine bay, but might as well since we're going to paint the outside. I mean,
yeah,
it's a real Saleen.
We're doing long tubes for it anyways. The oil pan need to be pulled. Hey, the engine's coming out if that stuff needs to be done. So, I mean, we do it right. I mean, check this stuff out. Yeah, we taped a few things up because we want to pull the dash. But, I mean, we pulled out throttle cable. Honestly, that wasn't that easy for the gas pedal. Clutch cable's always easy. Master cylinder or for, like, brake booster. Guys, I mean, me and Ty,
how long
we're doing, it takes me 7 minutes and 15 seconds. I know because we timed it. It takes you like 45 minutes. I think it took Mike
an hour and 25 minutes.
I don't think
minutes.
It took him that long.
It had to have.
I don't know.
Because I put him on Snapchat and it said like over an hour.
Yeah,
when
so anyways, I'm proud that honestly Sean and him can do it because it does. It sucks, you know?
You're laying on your back. And Mike's a big guy. I mean.
Yeah. So anyways, you always just got to use the right tools, sometimes from the right angles. Took me 7 minutes. I mean, honestly, it felt like an hour. But, I mean, we have fun. We make it a competition just as he can do it the fastest. Fox bodies are so much harder to take apart than S95s.
Yeah, I mean, under the dash, you can't even get your hands up in there, right?
Exactly,
it's just like caged and boxed in. So
but that's the right way to do it, you know? Honestly, if you've already got the engine out, it's going to take you, I mean, another 2 hours to take
everything. Let's just say another day to prep, to do it right.
Exactly, yeah.
I hate going to car shows and people, you know, have a nice exterior paint job, and then they pop the engine. They have, you know, $30,000 in the engine and chrome and all that bullshit, and then the fucking bolts are all oversprayed and half primered and shit. It just turns me off. I'm just like, dude, that thing's fucked. Yeah. So that's just how we are. And I don't mean to pick like that, but once we do 100 of these our way and correct, we don't even want to see them the other way.
Now, if it's a V6 car and the thing got hit in the front end and you just want a quickie spray, yeah, we'll tape the stuff up.
But they shouldn't be winning no first place trophies.
We actually like working on these Celines. We like people that like, you know, high-end, really nice stuff, because when we go to car shows, it shows.
It does.
And our friends honestly really do go to car shows, you know.
Especially Christian. He's going to be cruising this thing down in West Palm Beach, which we're leaving for West Palm Beach in about 5 days. And Nick Rollo is coming down from Connecticut. He's not bringing his Coyote Swap. I know you guys like that. Not sure what he's bringing. I think it's heavy snow up there right now. Mike with 3 E's is leaving, I think, Friday the 29th. So they're going to miss each other. But Mike's had to go back to work. He's in the military. So Rollo's going to take a week off. And he's going to come here, stay for a couple days, ride down to the journey to Florida with us. We're going to take Celine right there, 96-021, down there to West Palm Beach to Christian. So he owns this car, and then he owns that car as well. So both black Celines. Christian has actually bought another Celine from California. It's supposed to be shipped. I'm not sure if it's going to be here this week or not, but he already paid for it. It's kind of up to the weather and the guy that's actually bringing it up for him. I'm not sure, you know, what the weather's supposed to be like in the Midwest and stuff like that, or out west, should I say. So anyway, that's just a recap of what we've been doing. I did paint some of the parts to the semi. They're in the paint booth. You guys don't want to see none of that, so I'm not going to show that. But Cameron's really excited. He actually did get called in today. He was supposed to be off all week. But we kind of been showing Mike the town and doing, you know, taking the places he's never been and stuff like that. So anyway, enough with the talking. I'm going to spray this. I'm not going to time lapse it. You guys seen plenty of that, but we will walk through steps on it. Or I don't know, should we time lapse it or not?
Yeah, we'll time lapse.
Yeah, we'll time lapse it. Brent said it. So anyway, enjoy the time lapse and stay tuned. Undercoating in the inner fender. I'm gonna paint this when I paint the door jams and the quarter panel. So I'll just back tape it right here like I did on Brody's Fox body. We ordered all the new stickers for the front core support tonight. So they're going to be in. Here's the Celine tags. Install GT third door, because it takes a different wing than a standard GT hatch. And all these were LXs, so they were LXs with a, I guess, a GT hatch or something like that, Mike?
Yes.
Mike's cold. It's freezing right now. We have all the doors open for ventilation, and it's probably 10 degrees. So, kind of crazy to paint being this cold and not in the booth with heat or anything.
Well, you had heat when you vented it with the doors open to get all the clear dust.
It just doesn't look as smooth because there's so many holes, but again, this is a Celine, so we didn't want to shave the bay or anything like that. Christian just wanted it stock, which I totally agree with that. He does have a couple other Celines. Maybe we'll shave one and coyote swap it or something. We didn't really want to paint in here and clear coat. It just gets too dirty. And then I like the contrast of the undercoating flat black versus the clear coat gloss right here. So, what do you think, Mike?
I like your little invention here to hold the hood latches up too. The TK Blow special.
Yeah, you think you'd figure that out in Maryland?
No.
Think it's Indiana special?
But you'll probably see it on Instagram every 2 weeks now.
Oh yeah, Instagram every 2 weeks. What else did you do, Mike? You took the seats out?
Yeah, we took the seats out. When we took the doors out. Well, actually, I took the seats out after we took the engine out and then took the brake booster out. And me and BB were chasing some wiring gremlins, fixing all the radio bullshit since the radio was missing and chasing all this crap that goes wherever. Just needs a new center console or a new
Dellet
glove box or something.
Is that a cup holder right there that just
spawned? Yeah, I don't. I guess that's not stock, but
That's probably Steve's special.
Yeah, Steve liked 7-Eleven coffee when they first started coming out with the dollar cup, so makes sense.
And here's the big rig right here. Here's the motor. We're gonna put the long tube headers on it. Take these shorties off, put the Celine upper and lower intake on there with new gaskets. And here's CP's seats. His I think Christian's cat lived in there for like 3 years in the garage.
But it's still in good shape. I mean, besides the bolster, but this could get sewn on. Actually, the center part's in good shape. It just needs to be cleaned, in my opinion. But this one looks good. It's just dirty, but it is what it is.
Yep, and then here's the headrest, like Brent said, to catch the bugs if you're a convertible. So that way you get no bugs in the back seat.
30-year-old seats.
Yep. So anyway, that's it for tonight. Kind of the time lapse kind of sucked because I was just trying to get the shit done, and it was real fumy, as you guys can see, and that's kind of why I don't time lapse while I'm painting. And it was really cold, and I couldn't really get in and out for moving the camera around and stuff, so we'll do a better one next time. All right, Mike, in the video.
We did it, CP. We got the Fox 50% done, 25% done. Now we got to put all this shit back together and
put the motor in.
Put the motor in, put the struts in, clean up the underside, and then paint all this shit. So we'll probably keep another like 2 or 3 years, but it's whatever.
Fuck out some commas, yeah. Fuck out some commas, yeah. Fuck out some commas, yeah. 100,000 to 100,000. 100,000.